Hello friends, I am Dr. Tarpan Shah and I am back with a new video today, and the title for today's video is Do You Know This About the Stethoscope? Okay. Stethoscope is most commonly used clinical tools in our day-to-day clinical practice. Now, in this present video, I am going to give you an idea about the history of stethoscope, types of stethoscope, uses of stethoscope and the different parts of the stethoscope. I repeat, okay, history of stethoscope, types of stethoscope, parts of stethoscope and the uses of stethoscope. You are aware there are seven different types of stethoscope. Yes, there are seven different types of the stethoscope. Very strange, but yeah, there are seven different types of stethoscope. So let me tell you first about the history of the stethoscope. The stethoscope was first discovered by the Laennec. And when it was discovered, it was made up of the hollow wood and that was used for doing the auscultation. Recently, the stethoscope, what we are using, it is having the hollow rubber tube, air-filled hollow rubber tube. Okay, and these are the stethoscopes which we are using presently. Now, this is called acoustic stethoscope. This is called acoustic stethoscope. Remember one important point, the quality of stethoscope, it matters a lot for the auscultation, the quality of the stethoscope. And for that, rather than going with this one, acoustic stethoscope, it is always a better to go with the stereophonic stethoscope. I will tell you what is stereophonic stethoscope. So first, let me tell you about the parts of the stethoscope. Now, this is how we have to hold the stethoscope for keeping inside the ear. If we will hold it in this way and keeping it like this, we will be able to listen to the breath sound, heart sound very clearly and very easily. And if we are keeping it like this, then what will happen? This ear plugs or the ear buds, it is not going inside properly in the ear, so we are not able to clearly listen to the sounds. So this is for ear buds or the ear plugs. This is bineural connector. This is the rubber tubing. This entire thing is called chest piece. Both this entire thing is called chest piece. This is called bell. This is called diaphragm. And here we have a closer valve. So with the help of the closer valve, we can close and on, we can switch on and on in the same way, so that at a time only one will work, either the diaphragm or either the bell. So we have to remember, after keeping the stethoscope like this in the ear, the ideal way to hold the stethoscope is to hold in between the two fingers. Some doctors, they hold it like this also, so it is up to you, but the best way is to hold it like this. Now, it is always better directly don't keep the diaphragm or the bell on the skin part. Before that, the outer part of this diaphragm, it is made up of metal in many of the stethoscope. So it is a good practice that you apply the antiseptic solution or the sterilium, clean your hands properly, sterilize, then you rub this diaphragm in your hand and then you keep it on the skin surface. And try to do the auscultation on the bare skin rather than on the clothes. But if it is not possible or it has to be avoided, so in that case you do it with the help of the, on the clothes itself. Now here we have a closer valve, this which I have explained. Now what should be the length of this tube? Ideally 12 to 18 inch, not more than that or not less than that, to avoid the distortion. So there is an ideal length for this tube, and it should be 12 to 18 inch. Now this stethoscope will be very helpful for the four main reasons. The first one is to listen to the breath sound, bronchial, vesicular, bronchovesicular, tracheal, whether it is present, absent or any adventitious sound is present, etc. So for that we are doing auscultation on the anterior side, lateral side and the posterior side of the chest wall. So first use of the stethoscope is to listen to the breath sound. The second use of the stethoscope is to listen to the heart sound. With the help of the stethoscope, we can only listen to the S1 and S2 sound. S3 and S4 we cannot listen. So to listen to the normal and the abnormal heart sound, we call it as a murmur, systolic, diastolic, continuous, pansystolic, all murmurs, we can make use of the stethoscope. The third use is to check the blood pressure. Surprised? we use sphygmomanometer to check the blood pressure. Okay, but to check the blood pressure, we have two methods, direct methods and indirect methods. We use the indirect method for checking the blood pressure. And in indirect method, we have to use the sphygmomanometer, and along with that, we have to use the stethoscope when we check the blood pressure with the method of auscultatory method. The palpatory method, we can do it without stethoscope, but for auscultatory method, we need to have a stethoscope. So this is the third use. The fourth use of the stethoscope, just suppose a Ryle's tube or the nasogastric tube has been placed from the nose to the upper part of the stomach, and any water, milk, coconut water or anything which is in the liquid form which is introduced, and when it is going inside the stomach, one of the method to check whether it is going properly in the stomach or not, that is to do the auscultation by keeping the diaphragm on the stomach. That is the one method. Another method is to check with the help of the x-ray, of course, but these are the four main use of the stethoscope. The stereophonic, the second method of the second stethoscope, that is the same stethoscope by look and function and everything, but it is having the two separate tubings like this. So each here only one tube, and it is getting divided into two, and this we are keeping using it for the left and the right ear. Then you have a separate tubing for both the ear, and that's why it gives a good clarity of the sound, and most of the doctors, they prefer to use the stereophonic. Costing somewhere around 4,000 to 5,000 rupees, but worth purchasing and worth using. This is also good, but I must say the excellent one is the stereophonic one. Now, while teaching to the students, we face many problems, regarding the auscultation. So for that, we have a third variety of stethoscope, that is called teaching stethoscope. So it is same like this, but up to here, there is a second unit like this. So at a time, professors can keep this inside the ear, and even the students can also keep. And with the same diaphragm, where you are keeping it on the chest wall, the sound will be listened by the professor at the same time by the students as well. So it will enhance the teaching and the students can learn better. So this is the third variety of the stethoscope. I repeat up to here, acoustic, stereophonic and the teaching stethoscope. Now there are few other types of stethoscope. Okay, that is your magnetic stethoscope, electronic stethoscope, 3D stethoscope, and Doppler stethoscope. These are the other four varieties of the stethoscope. Magnetic stethoscope, not commonly used, but it is also available for the clinical practice. It is having a single end piece that is called diaphragm, and it contains an iron disc, on the interior surface behind the permanent magnet. Now any compression on the diaphragm will activate the air to the magnetic attraction, and changes in the frequency is adjusted for the high, low and the full frequency sounds. The another variety is your electronic stethoscope. Electronic stethoscope, it picks up any vibrations which will occur on the chest surface and convert it into the electrical impulse. Once the impulse is converted, it can be later on amplified and transmitted to the speaker, and then they are converted to the sound. And electronic stethoscope, it can also be used with the computer-aided auscultation programs to analyze the recorded heart sound. So analysis will become very easy with the help of the electronic stethoscope. The Doppler stethoscope is also the new, and it is also commonly used nowadays in few of the hospitals. And the latest one is your 3D stethoscope. You will be surprised that you must have heard about the 3D printing. What is this 3D stethoscope? 3D stethoscope is prepared with the help of the 3D printing machine itself. But why there was a need to invent the 3D stethoscope? So let me tell you something interesting about it. In the year 2015, it got very good media coverage and popularity that 3D stethoscope has been prepared, manufactured, and it has been in a practice. But the history dates back to Dr. Tarek and his team during the Glia project. At that time there was an acute shortage of the stethoscope, and that need or the necessity has directed them to develop the 3D stethoscope. It works on the same principle of the Littmann's 1960 stethoscope, and then they have developed the 3D stethoscope. It is also used nowadays into the few advanced setup. So to summarize this particular video, I would like to say that laennec has developed this, discovered the stethoscope. The parts of the stethoscope: ear plug or the earpiece, binaural connectors, tubing, chest piece, diaphragm, and the bell, and the closing and opening valve. Four main uses of the stethoscope: to check for the breath sound, to check for the heart sound, to check for the blood pressure measurement, and to check for the right tube, whether it is properly placed or not. Apart from this, many other usages. And there are seven main types of the stethoscope: acoustic, stereophonic, teaching, electronic, magnetic, Doppler, and the 3D printed stethoscope. I wish this video will be helpful to you to know about the clinical tools called stethoscope. Thank you very much.